Hey, 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 Uncle Mark in the mothership with a three-string cigar box guitar. And this is the Top Gun theme. So I got a lot of requests for the Top Gun theme, the intro that I do before I play Danger Zone when I play this stuff live. So I figured I would dig a little bit deeper, and then I would show you exactly how to play that cool little da 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 da. Okay, so this is what we're going to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press on a backing track for the song, and it's the exact song backing behind what I'm going to play. And then we'll talk about my thinking and how it all works, and my hand positions and things like that. So here we go. We're waiting for the crescendo at 1 minute and 31 seconds. Here we go. That's the Top Gun theme. That's the hand position that you want to use. And so when I do it, I do the same thing. This is actually in C. I do it in D because I play Danger Zone in D. A couple of caveats. Danger Zone is actually in D sharp. And so if you wanted to do that, you'd be in D sharp. That's kind of how I explored this idea. So what I'm going to do is leave that behind, that backing track. And down below in the show notes, I will leave you the timing of that. And then that way you can play along and try to get your timing exactly right. So what it looks like in the real world is... So what are we doing here? So I am playing with my fingers like so. So everything, every note that I play in the ninth fret is going to be played with this first finger. Every note, and that includes each string at any time. Any note in the 10th fret, I'm going to play with my second finger, my big ring finger. Married ring finger will play everything in the 11th fret, and my pinky will play everything that is in the 12th fret. And that's how I want you to approach this. As you get better at playing, your pinky is going to get stronger, or you're going to decide to work this finger a little bit out of position. So if this is the position you want, that would be out of position. But you may like that, using that finger for that note. I do that a lot. I like that finger for that note. So this is in C, and there is your C note. That's your resolution note. And that's the note you start on. So you're gonna play, you're gonna work it this way. C, C, G. Da 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 da. That's how you want to work it. So here are the notes. So start with C with that second finger. Then you're going to go to the high G 12th fret. Then that F to E back and forth. D string 12th fret. So. That's what we've got so far. And I want you to work on your fingering being exactly like so. It's going to really come in handy when you shift. When you make the shift to F sharp, it's really going to be handy to have your hand working this way. So again, C, G, F, E, F, G, D, D. And from there, we're going to go to the C again. That's how it works. So that's what you're looking at and keeping your hand here. So the best thing to do really is to vocalize this. Ba, 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 ba. When you vocalize your playing, what happens is your brain engages more and a little stronger. Your brain will engage stronger using vocalization. Anytime you're doing a solo and you can vocalize it in practice, you really will get it down a lot tighter. So we're in C. The first thing. So get this again. C, D, G, F, E, F, D, D, C, D, E, D, E, F, D, E, D, E, C, D, D. There we go. The second time through it ends. Note, it does a. Then it shifts. Your hand shifts and you come up here to the F sharp. Your hand doesn't care or doesn't know the difference between this and this. The position of your hand is exactly the same. Okay? All you're doing is moving your first finger, okay, up to that right here. So it'd be 15. 12, 13, 14, 15. You come up to the 15th fret, 15, 16, 17, 18, and that's where you play this. Don't think tabs, think ear. I want you to hear this and listen to it and hear it by listening to it. So you go through one time down here, two iterations. First iteration ends. There, second iteration ends here. through. Now you come up to the F sharp. Second iteration at the F sharp. Now you're back again. The song is in C, and at that moment, it goes to B flat. But you don't have to worry about that. We're just doing that initial section, and I'm going to do it again with the backing track, and I'm going to put the backing track back to 120, and it comes in at 131, and that gives you a good idea of where to come in. So I'm at 120. Waiting for the keyboard crescendo. Da, da. And you're getting ready. You got your finger there on C. Show you this. So what I do before Danger Zone is I actually play it in D, but it's the same shape. I go into Danger Zone, but actually I play it in D. The original is in C and then F sharp up here. So your first finger's on the 15th fret, and that's how it works out. A lot of times I use my third finger replacing my pinky when I'm in this upper register above the 12th fret. Everything below the 12th fret is the lower register. Everything above the 12th fret's the upper register. And that's how I divide the guitar in half. Thank you so much. This has really been a lot of fun. I love doing this intro. It kind of throws a twist into the Danger Zone song, and it really marries it together really nicely. It's a great homage to Top Gun, that wonderful 80s movie. And now the success of the modern Top Gun, the Maverick, is it's really good. It's fun to play. Everybody knows it. And so you can put this together, or you can just play it as a trick. And just play it to get your fingers stronger and work out these parts. So thank you so much for everything you do. We are a 100% all donation channel. The only